Hello everyone, my name is Anna from Tip Top Sewing, and today I'm going to share with you my 2018 Read Sew Solutions. It's a hashtag started by Candy from Cotton by Candy and Boss from A Girl Called Boss. So I decided to join this tag. But first of all, I'll tell you what I'm wearing. It's a Prada style dress that I made with last year, and I'll leave a link in the description so you can see more and you can see what pattern and what fabric I used. Number one is, what's your favorite make of 2017 and why? It's very difficult to pick just one make because I like them all, but I would say that it's a keyhole dress from Patrick. It was definitely a new and unique experience for me to sew something like that because it's a very interesting dress, it has a very interesting design, and it's a bit... it shows a bit more than a usual dress, than a usual dress of this kind of type, but at the same time it's still very nice and elegant, and it was inspired by Marilyn Monroe, as probably many of you know if you were interested in sewing this pattern before. It still doesn't reveal anything it shouldn't reveal, and I also took my time to get the perfect fit, which was also quite satisfying because when you achieve a good fit, it's always nice. So I really like this dress, and it's not something I can wear every single day or on a daily basis, but it's definitely a dress that I really want to have in my wardrobe. Number two is, what did you attempt to do in 2017 that you won't be doing this year and why? So I definitely don't want to use a clear elastic again. Last year I made a Prada dress that was made of jersey, obviously, and it was a really nice make, and I really enjoy wearing it and I really enjoyed working on it because it's a very straightforward pattern, but I really hated using a clay elastic. This was the first time I did it because before I was just using regular pie strip for certain projects, for certain jersey projects, and it was just horrible. First of all, it was very difficult to sew it because you need a special sewing machine feet, you need a special needle, but needle isn't such a big deal. And another problem is that it completely blocked my sewing machine with those tiny little pieces of the tape that you end up with when the machine needle is piercing through the tape. So I did my best to clear it, but I still believe it's not a very good thing for my sewing machine to be blocked by that, and I'm definitely not going to use this clear elastic anymore, and I'm going to use just a regular elastic. Number three is, what are you going to continue doing? So obviously I'm going to continue sewing some vintage style dresses because I know that some people believe that even though it's very nice style, but you don't really have many occasions to wear it, and I can't really agree with that. I believe that we have plenty of occasions. It all depends on what exactly you're sewing, because obviously if you're making only summer dresses because they look nice and cute and it's quite easy to sew them to work with cotton, then yes, but if you still make different blouses, you make different jackets, skirts as well, it's quite easy to incorporate all those pieces into your day-to-day wardrobe. So sewing vintage spine dresses and skirts and blouses and just using vintage reproduction patterns and retro style patterns is definitely something I'll carry on doing this year. Number four is, what are you going to try this year? And I know I probably say it every single year, but it's sewing bras, and once again, I said it probably at least, well, a couple of times before, but this year I'm actually serious about it, and I'm going to start sewing my first bra, which is going to be a Watson set from Cloth Habit. So I'm going to start sewing it very soon, like probably next month. Number five is, where do you see your handmade wardrobe by the end of this year, and what about 5 years? So as for this year, I pretty much see it the same. The only difference is I think I'm going to try to sew more separate, so it's so I always have something to combine with, not just wear dresses and. But in general, it's going to be pretty much the same. It's going to be all about practical and classy garments, including vintage style dresses and blouses and tops and skirts and jackets as well, and maybe even winter coats. As for 5 years, I guess it's going to be the same as well. The only thing is, I think I'll try to make sure that I have at least 99% of garments in my wardrobe that I made myself. Because even though I generally buy any clothes at the moment, I only make clothes. Obviously, I still have some really nice ready-to-wear pieces in my wardrobe that I don't want to get rid of, but I'm definitely not going to buy anything else, anything new. That's it for today. Let me know what your sewing resolution are for this year in the comments, or make a video and join the hashtag as well. If you would like to see what I'm actually working on and how I'm progressing with my plans for this year, you can follow me on Instagram at tiptopsewing. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel so you can see more. And I'll see you next time. Bye!